The first thing that we need to do to install n8n on DigitalOcean is to spin up a DigitalOcean droplet. And you can do that by heading off to the website digitalocean.com. There is a link in the information underneath of the video that will take you to the website and give you a $200 credit for 60 days, more than enough time for you to test out DigitalOcean and n8n. Once you've created a DigitalOcean account and you've logged on, the first thing we need to do is to create the droplet. And we do that by clicking on the green Create button at the top of the screen and clicking onto Droplets. Then you need to select the location of where to host your droplet, so pick somewhere nearby to you. For me, this is going to be London. And then the next section, choose an image. So if you select Ubuntu, and if you select the version, the one that is pre-selected here should be fine. In my case, it's 24.10x64. Under the choose a size section, make sure you have basic selected. Under CPU options, select regular, and then select the $6 a month droplet. Now, it's fairly small, this, but we have managed to build incredibly complex workflows and a lot of them on this size of droplet, and it hasn't flickered at all. The good thing with DigitalOcean is it's easy to upsize the droplet if you do ever outgrow this. Next, you need to choose an authentication method. Now, if you're familiar with this stuff, you can select SSH keys to SSH into the droplet, or you can select the password. The way I'm going to share this with you, it doesn't really matter which way you do this. So to keep things nice and easy, I'm just going to use a password. Just make sure that whichever you do create meets the requirements that are listed underneath. And the final thing that we need to do is to give our droplet a host name. So I'm just going to call this n8n demo. Pick something which is easy to remember for you. And once we've done that, we can then click create droplet at the bottom. And this will then start spinning up the droplet. We're just waiting for the blue line to get to the end there. Now, once we've got to this point, you can see that the droplet has been created and it's given us an IP address. In order to make sure that we can access n8n from our web browser, you will need to create an A record with your DNS registrar. Now, depending upon where your domain name is hosted, the instructions for this will be different. I have added a link into the article comments at the bottom here, which will take you off to the HubSpot website, which gives a really good overview or instructions for some of the more common ones out there. Mine is hosted with Cloudflare, so I'm going to copy this and head to my DNS records. I need to click onto add record. I'm going to add an A record, and I'm going to call this for this video demo. So this is going to be demo.automatethis.com. So I just need to put demo into this box and then paste in the IP address. In my case, I don't want this to be proxied. You might not have that option. And then just click on to save, and that will create my A record. So I'm all ready to go with that. Now we need to start the process of installing n8n and the components required for n8n to work. I mentioned before, if you have experience with this, you can SSH into the server. If you haven't, or you just want a quick and easy way of doing this, just click onto the droplet. And once the next page opens here, just click onto this console button here. And what that will do, it will open up the console required to install DigitalOcean. I'm just going to expand this so you can see it properly. The reason I like this for is, like many of the terminals which you can use, DigitalOcean's terminal has copy and paste ability, so we can just copy and paste the command to install n8n onto our server. Now, all we need to do from this point then is to copy and paste the commands that you will see in the details below the video, whether you're on the website or on YouTube. I've added them in both places. Essentially, like I said, we just need to copy and paste the commands one at a time and allow them to run. So the first thing we're going to do is to make sure that our server software is up to date. So we're going to paste over the update and upgrade command. That'll take a minute or so for that to run. Okay, now that's completed. After each and every command, you're waiting to get back to this point in the terminal where you can see everything is completed and it's now waiting for the next command. So next we just need to install some dependencies, so we just paste in the next command. And now we need to install a piece of software called Docker. Now Docker is going to allow us to manage and upgrade n8n in future. It's a nice and easy way of doing this. So the next command in here, and essentially now we just keep pasting in the commands until the point where we get to here and we issue another update command, which will just install all of those bits and pieces into the server, which will allow n8n to install. Next, we're going to install Docker. So we just install it at the next command. It's going to take a couple of seconds to run. Okay, that one is now complete. We're going to check it's installed by just running a sudo docker version command. And that will show us now that we have Docker version 27.3.1 build, etc., etc. Yours might be different depending upon when you do this, but essentially this does mean now that it is installed. Next, we're going to install something called Docker Compose. This is just an additional piece that connects to Docker that allows us to manage and start n8n. So we're just going to paste in that command and the next command from the list. And similar again, we're going to run a version command just to check that Docker Compose is installed. And again, we get that Docker Compose version in the window. Next command is to enable Docker. And then finally, in this case, we're going to start Docker. So right now we are ready to start installing n8n and a piece of software called Caddy. Now, Caddy is a piece of software which will run n8n in the browser, essentially. It makes sure that we can see it when we go to the website. Now, to do this, we're going to move to a different directory. So what we're going to do here is to type cd space forward slash home. And then we're going to copy over the next command, which is the git clone. That will bring that in. And next command is going to move us to a different directory again, which has been created from that last command. So cd n8n hyphen docker hyphen caddy. Now we need to create just a couple of additional data folders. So the next good commands are the create caddy data and create n8n data. Excellent. Next two steps, we need to open up two ports on the firewall, port 80 and port 443. Perfect. Now, if you aren't used to doing things like this, this next bit is probably the trickier part. What we need to do now is to make some adjustments to the configuration files. So the first one we're going to do a work on is the .env file. So we issue the command nano space .env. This is going to open up a text editor. Nano is a text editor, and this will allow us to change the configurations to our needs. So we pop in nano space .env and enter, and this opens up a text editor. And you need to use your keyboard arrow keys to move around this folder. So the first thing that we need to change then is this data folder. So you can see right now it's got forward slash open triangle bracket directory hyphen path closed triangle bracket. We need to delete that part out and change this to home. This is the directory that we moved to a little bit earlier. Next, domain name and subdomain name. So this is where we're going to tell n8n and Caddy where we're going to host our instance. So domain name is the main domain name that you were using. So in my case, this was automatethis.com. You need to add in whatever your domain name is in here. And the subdomain, remember earlier I created demo. Now I'm going to change the time zone. So I'm in Europe, London. You'll need to change this to whatever your local time zone is. And again, in the details under the video, I've added a link to a website where you can see what all of those time zones are. And the final thing we need to do is to add in an email address. So delete example at example.com out and add in an email address where you can receive updates for the SSL certificate. Once you're happy with all of that, you're going to press Control and X on your keyboard. And at the bottom here, you can see it says Save Modified Buffer. We're just going to press the Y key on our keyboard. And it'll suggest file name to write.env. We don't need to change anything other than now than press Enter on your keyboard. And that is that part done. Now we need to make some changes to something called the Caddy file. So we're going to paste in the next command. So nano caddy underscore config forward slash caddy file. And the bit we need to change here is the part at the top, where right now it's got n8n.domain.suffix. So we need to delete all of that out and add in the full domain name of where you're going to host n8n. So in my case, it's demo.automatethis.com. Once you're happy with that, Control X, yes, and enter. Now, once we've got to this point, we can start up n8n, and we do that by running the command sudo docker compose up hyphen d. This will take a few seconds to complete. We're just waiting for it to download, extract, and install all of the files and information needed. And once you get these three green words created, started, and started, that means that n8n is now up and running. And we can head back to our web browser, demo.automatethis.com domain. And it's now going to ask me to create a user account. So I'm just going to add in my email address, my first name, last name, and then create a password. If you want to sign up for their newsletter, you can just click the little box here, but essentially click on to next. Fill in the pre-questions and click on to get started. If you do see this option to get these paid features for free, I do highly recommend that you do it. I'll talk through in another video about how to do this, but for now we're just going to click on to skip. And that is how to install n8n on a DigitalOcean droplet. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like and subscribe to the channel if you would like to see more like this. Thanks for now.